Installation 6 in the main entrance to the show. It's the first thing that our visitors see. It's the thing that they rush towards to get their photo taken. This year, we came up with the Best of Rushish theme. This year, I'm really looking for something that's bold and interactive. And I'm hoping that what Rosie has come up with is exceptional. It fits the brief and wows the public.
We are going along with the theme. We've got a king bulldog, and he's going to be sitting on a highly decorated gold throne with red furnishings. As well as doing the actual cake, I've now been asked to make a second throne that the public can sit in, which is great fun. I mean, the idea that they can all sit there, have their photo taken with our dog, it's going to be a lot of fun.
This giant dog will be made from vanilla sponge and marshmallow and rice cereal mix, covered in fondant for his fur and features. Rosie will also make not one, but two thrones. One for the dog, which will include an edible cushion, and another, non-edible version for the visiting public to have their photo taken on. It will take her over 2 weeks to make.
I've given him a name. I'm calling him Big Ben. Very British, very patriotic. Whether or not I'll be able to do it on the scale that I want is another matter, but I'm going to give it a good go.
First up, Rosie begins building her two thrones.
This is going to sit the bulldog or the person, so it's capable of doing both. It's made out of wood, it's collapsible so I can fix it in the car. Frankly, it's a bit of a work of art as far as I'm concerned.
Rosie is covering the throne in plaster of Paris decorations, which she sprays gold before adding a velvet cushion. She'll then make a second edible version for the bulldog to sit on.
This, I've now got to do in edible form, so I'm looking at getting the colour right, getting the texture right, and I haven't even started on the cake yet.
In Chelmsford, Essex, Eloise is adding some finishing touches for her cake and bake piece, and is covering it in a thick layer of chocolate ganache.
So I'm just trying to orientate myself around it. This is time.
And there's still so much to do.
I've got the cape with the Union Jack on. I've got the dog himself. Colouring that is not going to be a breeze. I'm going to effectively be doing a 3D painting, so I need to get a move on.
With the ganache set, she adds some facial definition with strips of sugar paste and covers Big Ben in melted sugar syrup.
This is ever so slightly hot still, which means when I put the icing on, it's really going to appear. I can see him taking shape. I'm going for a cross between Winston Churchill and Henry VIII.
As the fondant dries, Rosie moves on to the crown made from rice cereal and melted marshmallows.
I'm going to cover this with chocolate, cover it with icing, and then it's down to edible gems.
Those edible gems are made from isomalt, a sugar substitute. She pours into molds to set.
This is actually why I do it. All the rest of it is just getting me to this bit so I can play with sugar.
Once the crown is sumptuously adorned, it's time for the mammoth paint job that will bring Big Ben to life.
I'm nowhere near finished on the face yet. I'm just kind of trying to do little bits and pieces, let them dry, come back to it. I'm just doing this rough. This is the last thing that needs to dry. So if I can get this on now, then I'm going to do all those bits that will finish it off nicely.
With the cake nearing completion, Rosie's thoughts turn to the potentially problematic delivery.
I'm worried about the weight of this dog. I'm worried about the logistics of moving him because that's going to be really tough.
In London, her Big Ben bulldog cake for the baking show in London.
We live in the north of England. It's the law that it rains here on delivery day. So once it's in the car, I will be happy. If I damage this on the way, I will be absolutely mortified, and I am worried about the crown.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
There we go. Are you in?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, people are absolutely sweating.
With Big Ben safely en route, the pressure's now on to impress over 25,000 baking enthusiasts. But that can only happen if the cake has survived the journey.
I'm got here.
But before Big Ben can make his grand entrance, there's the small matter of building the two thrones.
This is the one that the public can sit on and have their photo taken. So the whole thing is designed to entertain and to ensure that people can go away with a photo of themselves and take.
Said built. It's finally time for the guest of honor to take his throne.
No, he's in. That's it.
Ready for his coronation.
Can't wait for the public to come in. I hope they love it. I love it.
Weighing in at almost 5 stone, the cake bulldog is completely edible. From the crown on his head to the cushion he sat on, complete with sugar jewels and a fondant cake, Big Ben takes center stage as he's revealed to his adoring public.
3, 2, 1,
so, as the visiting guests grab a selfie, it's time to see what event organizer Giles makes of the cake.
Absolutely unbelievable, you know, from the crown to the cloak, the expression, you know, on the dog's face, it, the